We all are aware, I think I've talked to this church, when Moses was going to Egypt to bring the children of Israel from bondage, what was the message? Let my people go, that they may worship
me.
That says the Lord. Let my people go, that they may worship me. That was the message. Moses was not saying, let my people go, that says the Lord, that they go and occupy the land of promise. The business of God is that he may be worshipped. Why is God going with that message so strongly? Because in Exodus chapter number 2, and verse number 24, God missed something and he remembered. I hope you are there. Exodus chapter 2 verse 24, God had their groaning and God remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac and with Jacob.
Mungu akasikia kilio chake chao na akakumbuka hali yake na Abrahamu, Isaka na Yakobo.
Listen to me.
Excuse me.
For God now to have mercy upon the Israelites,
ila Mungu apate rehema kwa wana wa Israeli,
who were groaning in Egypt,
walikuwa wanalia kule Egypt,
he could just decide to save them out,
angeamua tu awakomboe,
but he remembered,
lakini akakumbuka
his covenant,
agano lake
with who? Abraham, Isaac and Jacob.
Abraham, Isaac and Jacob.
Who are these?
How
are
they named?
Because in the same land of promise, when Abraham came from Mesopotamia,
wakati Abraham alitoka Mesopotamia,
and arrived in the land of Canaan,
na akafika mule Canaan.
You know, people think Canaan was promised only to the children of Israel when they were in Egypt. No. Promised land was given to
Abraham.
And God took him there. According to Genesis chapter 12. I want you to see this. When Abraham came, Abraham raised an altar. And in total, Abraham raised 4 altars.
Abraham alinua madhabahu manne
to worship God,
ili amwabudu Mungu,
to have burnt offerings for God.
Akawa na dhabihu za kuteketeza kwake Mungu.
The same land,
mule mule,
Isaac had 1 altar.
Isaac akainua dhabihu za madhabahu.
In the same land,
kwa ile nchi,
Jacob raised 2 altars.
Yakobo akainua dhabihu za madhabahu mbili.
In total,
yote ikiwa
Abraham, Isaac and Jacob, they raised 7 altars. Number 7 is a complete number. Number 7 is associated with the faithfulness and accomplishment of Jehovah God. Are you following me, church? Please follow me, because I will take you to yourself. Where you need to check yourself. And then I take you to God. Very, very important. This is why we are here today. Now listen. When you hear people pray, and I've said this many times, when I am calling Jehovah, you hear them saying, oh God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob, they don't go beyond there, because the covenant of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob have great respect, which respect? They worship God. Now God remembered that, and he, that on those altars, I enjoy worship. Now I'm missing worship. Moses, can you go and bring them out? Go and tell the king, go.
Wacha watu wangu
waende. That they may worship me.
Na ili waweze kuniabudu.
If you think God was rescuing them because he had mercy on them.
Kama unafikiri Mungu aliwakomboa sababu alikuwa na huruma.
And he was so controlled by the love he had.
Na aliongozwa na upendo alikuwa nao.
You may be wrong.
Unaweza kuwa unakosea.
God was looking for worship.
Mungu alikuwa anatafuta kuabudiwa.
If it were not for that,
kama sio kuabudiwa,
he would not have killed them in the wilderness.
Angewaua kwenye jangwa.
He's so merciful.
Na kwa wale rehema nyingi.
Why is he quarreling with them?
Bwana anapigana na wao.
Because he demands worship.
Manake anataka kuabudiwa.
They have decided to go otherwise.
Lakini wameamua kwenda njia zingine.
Are you following me?
Unanifuata?
Now look at this. When Pharaoh refused and made his heart very hard, the 10 plagues were sent. All those manner of sicknesses were there. The locusts, darkness and everything. And death was over. We are praying today. Because there is a very heavy cloud of destruction. But our God who is faithful, He is saying, if my people who are called by my name
will
humble themselves. That's why I like about my God. Now, my brothers and sisters, let's look at this. When one time we are still looking at where God is demanding worship. Give us this 2 Kings chapter number 17. Give us verse there, 2 Kings chapter 17.
Yes.
The king of Assyria brought people from Babylon to the Hamath. And some of them and settled them in the towns of Samaria to replace the Israelites. They took over Samaria and lived in its towns. Verse 25. When they first lived there, they did not worship the Lord. So he sent lions among them and they killed some of them. Look at that. It's about to worship. And I tell you, when God is demanding worship, He can send anything. What is happening here? One time the children of Israel were taken into captivity from Samaria. Hello?
Hello?
If you know very well, Samaria is the central part of
Canaan.
Even when we came to the New Testament, you find there is
Galilee
and there is Judea.
Judea.
But in the middle we have Samaria.
Samaria.
So these people were right in the middle. And they were taken captive and removed from their native land. But the captors, who is the king of Assyria, he brought other people from
Babylon
to come and enjoy the land of Samaria. But what do you find? When they stayed there, they didn't know how to worship. They never gave the Lord God of Israel worship. They never sacrificed to Jehovah. They continued to win their lives, sacrificing to idols. So God sent lions and killed some of them. Verse 26. That's where we are, verse 26. It was reported to the king of Assyria, the people you deported and settled in the towns of Samaria do not know what the God of that country requires. I like that. There is something the God of the nation that requires. He has sent lions among them, which are killing them all, because the people do not know what he requires. I insist on that. People do not know what he requires. And like we say, that when you talk of innocence, you can't say ignorance shall be forgiven. Whether they know or not, hey, he requires worship. So what happened? Verse 27. Then the king of Assyria gave this order. Have one of the priests you took captive from Samaria go back to live there and teach the people what the God of the land requires. Amen.
Amen.
28, we finish. So one of the priests who had been exiled from Samaria came to live in Bethel and taught them how to worship the Lord. What is the meaning of Bethel? Bethel means the house of God.
Bethel inamaanisha nyumba ya Mungu.
Beth is house.
Bethel inamaanisha nyumba.
El is Jehovah. E-L. El Shaddai. El Sham. El J. That is Jehovah.
So the house.
So the priest came to Bethel. And started teaching people how to worship God.
Why
don't we see verse 29 also? It is important. Nevertheless, each national group made its own gods in the several towns where they settled and set them up in the shrines. And the people of Samaria, and the shrines the people of Samaria had made at the high places. So they never changed. Oh, I to them. Now, after seeing that, my brothers and sisters, where are we now?
Sisi tuko wapi?